Yes, welcome. We look at ethanol. We say that ethanol is the most important alcohol. It's the most important what? Alcohol. It's so important that it is called alcohol because it is the most important ingredient of the alcohol drinks, the alcoholic drinks that we take. You understand? When you take something like, some people take beer, gin, spirit, all those things, they contain ethanol. You understand? That ethanol, that's what makes it intoxicating. When you take it, you want to, like, you feel tipsy. You understand? Because of this chemical, ethanol. Ethanol is very, very important. It is used in doing many things. You understand? All those things, when you get to the hospital, you, something is burning you, you can apply it, it relieves you, you understand? It is used in many products, many things. It forms ingredients for many things. So it has the molecular formula of what? C2H5OH. That's the molecular formula. And it has the molecular structure of this. This is the molecular structure. CC8. 8 is always 2, but then it has the functional group OH. Then with the normal HH. You understand? It is the essential ingredient in alcoholic drinks because of its intoxicating effect on what? Consumers. Because of its intoxicating effect on what? Consumers. Preparation. There are two ways of preparing ethanol. It could be in the laboratory or what? Commercial. Laboratory is the one you prepare very small, you want to use for experimental stuff. Commercial is the one you prepare, you want to sell. You understand? So in the lab, you can prepare by hydrolyzing iodo-18 with what? An alkali. You can also do that by hydrolyzing ethyl esters with what? Hot alkali. Or reducing ethanol with what? Nascent hydrogen. Those are the three ways of preparing in the lab. But commercially, the one you sell for drinks and other things, you produce them from what? Ethane. By hydrolyzing with what? Boiling water. Or famously, and the one we do locally mostly, by what? Fermentation. That's the one we use in producing alcohol in the village, everywhere. If you come to my village, we prepare a lot of kai-kai there. You understand? So the traditional way of fermentation, that's what most people use. Fermentation is the slow decomposition of macroorganisms of large organic what? Molecules. The slow decomposition of microorganisms of large organic molecules, such as starch, into smaller molecules such as what? Ethanol. So when you break down starch to form ethanol, it is called fermentation. And it is a slow process. You understand? This is normally done in the presence of enzymes known as what? Catalysts. There are sources of this starch or material for fermentation. Number one is starchy foodstuff. Number two is molasses, which is a sugar syrup. And number three is from other sources like grapes, plantain, pineapple, sugar cane, honey. You know that if you leave your pineapple for some time, it will get sour taste. That is fermentation, is it not? So it's not only starch that does fermentation. Grapes, plantain, most of them, when you leave them for some time, in the presence of some enzyme, they will ferment. So when you taste them, the taste will be somehow. You understand? That is fermentation. So know that fermentation is one of the major ways of what? Producing ethanol. And it's simply the word slow decomposition by microorganisms. Slow decomposition by what? Microorganism. So you need microorganism to do fermentation. You understand? Of large organic molecules, such as starch, into smaller molecules, such as what? Ethanol. In the presence of enzymes known as catalysts. And sources of this fermentation material could be starchy foodstuff, molasses, or other sources like grapes, plantain, pineapple, sugar, honey, heat, etc. Thank you.